That is the first flat record, and that's from 1881. Who knows what it's worth? How can something that old not be worth a lot? I have bought 1 million albums in the archive, and about 1.5 million singles. The Library of Congress did a study on the merchandise that I have in my collection, and from 48 to 66, they decided that only 17% of that music is available to the public on CD. Now, do you think about that for a second? That means 83% of the music that I have on those shelves you can't buy at any price anywhere.
This is probably the store's single most valuable record. This album was never commercially released for the consumer, and it's very rare. It's worth anywhere from $6,000 to $10,000. And this is a brand new copy.
Well, I used to be a salesman on the road for Morse Paper Company, and while I was out on the road, I always kept my eye open for recordings and music, and I acquired this and that, and I used to meet collectors and used to trade a lot. Any way I could get the records that I didn't have or that I loved, I did that for years and years.
So we just bought a new house, and he would keep coming home with records and more records and more records. So after he had about 60,000 records or so in my basement, I said, look, here's the deal. Either you go open up a store or get rid of the records. And he said, oh, okay, I'll do that. And I said, if you want a name, call it Record-rama.
To become an archive, you had to maintain a collection of one copy of every recording you ever got. So I would never sell the last copy of anything. That's why it was an archive, and it still is an archive to this moment. People come in here once in a while and they ask for a song, and my eyes light up and I feel like I'm part of the human race. That happens rarer and rarer and rarer every day. It's a sad commentary on the times. I've spent the last 10, 12 years trying to find a home for my collection, and basically nobody gives a damn. And I mean that from my heart. I'm going to be 69 years old in September. I've given my whole life to this, but I have to give it up. What really makes me want to save this collection is the world is dead out there. They have their ears closed. They don't understand what's going on at this moment. And it's going to take them 10, 15, 20 years to wake up and realize what they missed. The music is 100 times better on a vinyl album. And I've had problems with all the kids. They don't believe me. They don't think that's true. First of all, just imagine this. They move the music by computer, and what they do is they chop off the highs, they chop off the lows, and then they compress everything. How could that possibly be equal to the open sound that you get on a record with the basses and the highs and the fullness in the middle? I mean, there's no comparison to what they're selling for music these days. The days of vinyl, as we used to know it, is pretty well over. It's a shame. It breaks my heart.
Just the thought that someone could actually achieve what he did and I guess be able to collect everything that's here is quite a tribute.
It's heartbreaking to see that the world doesn't care or give a damn about saving it for future generations. That is depressing. But I am not going to throw my life away because everybody out there is sleeping. I've already given my life to this collection. If nobody out there understands what I've done and what I have and what I've offered, then we have to give it up.
Music was my first love. Music of the future, music of the past, the music of the past.
My life song. I've given my life to music. It's all it's called is music.